on a daily, like on a second to second.
They do. They ask us all the time.
Clamor for that.
Yeah. Like, what do you put in your tea, milk or honey?
Let me help you out. Not even my family cares. Yeah.
Yes, they do.
You know what? Everyone is caring about this cold, windy weather. It sure does look pretty, though, doesn't it? We're looking live in Long Beach. Nice, clear skies. Definitely cold outside, and the wind's not helping at all. Temperatures well below average. Our daytime high, we should be into the 70s. That would be nice, wouldn't it? We were into the low 60s. It felt more like the 50s, though, because of those winds. Overnight lows into the 40s as well. So, again, those cold temperatures at night and in the morning hours. And then we just have the warm-up come in the middle of the day, but it doesn't last long at all. We do have some warmer temperatures in the 5-day, and then we've got some rain as well. So, quite a mix of weather the next 5 days. Let's take a look at those current temperatures. We're anywhere from 57 degrees in Long Beach, 53 in Corona, 53 also in Riverside. Valencia coming in into the 40s, 48 degrees in Sunland. In Malibu, we're into the mid-50s. It is 52 degrees in Thousand Oaks. But what's happening is those winds are picking up. So if you've got the wind chill factor in place. We also have the wind advisories in place as well. Right around 8 miles an hour from Hawthorne to Malibu, up to 14 now in Fillmore. Winds very strong in Ontario at 15 miles an hour. And to Temescal, winds are up to around 10 miles an hour. Now, we've got the wind advisories for the mountains in the Santa Clarita Valley, and that's the mountains of LA and Ventura counties through noon tomorrow. So those winds could be up to 50 miles an hour. So be careful driving along the 14 or the 5. Dangerous. You definitely want both hands on the steering wheel there. It is also very cold. So the Inland Empire under that frost advisory, as well as the interior valleys of Ventura County, where temperatures before sunrise tomorrow, there'll be a couple hours where temperatures will be into the upper 20s to low 30s. So cold and a windy night tonight. Want to show you why we've got this change in the weather. We do have plenty of sunshine. That area of low pressure has moved off, but what's happening is all that cold air started rushing in behind it. That ridge of high pressure is nudging in, but it's nudging in from the south and west. So we still have that northerly flow. Eventually, it will be a little more out of the northeast in the next few days, and that's why our temperatures will warm up midweek. But then another storm system bringing wet weather to our north for now could bring us about a 20% chance of some light showers by the weekend. So not a big rain event in store right now. It could change as we get closer. But right now we're just looking